Anthropic recently released the Claude 3 models in three variants: Claude 3 Haiku, Claude 3 Sonnet, and Claude 3 Opus. Haiku, which is the cheapest and fastest model, Sonnet, which strikes a good balance between performance and intelligence, and lastly, we have Opus, which is the most advanced of the three models. According to the Anthropic website, the Claude Opus model beats the GPT-4 model in pretty much every benchmark. What's also interesting is that the smallest model, Haiku, beats GPT-4 or comes very close in certain benchmarks as well. What I do appreciate about these Claude models is that they are really fast. These response times can be a game changer if you're building customer support chatbots, as an example. These models are also multimodal, and we can use its vision capabilities to chat to a wide variety of file types, including PDF documents, flowcharts, or even presentation slides. And according to the benchmarks, the Opus model is extremely competitive with the GPT-4 vision model. All three of these models offer a 200,000 token context window size, and these models can also exceed 1 million tokens if that's what you need. Before we write any code, let me first introduce you to the Anthropic console. You can access the console by going to the Anthropic website at anthropic.com, and you can then click on API, and from this page, click on Get Started Now. You will need to create a free account, and you will also receive some free credit to get started. So after accessing the console, you should see a page like this. And what we are interested in is to generate an API key. But before we do that, I just want to show you one very cool feature about using this dashboard. So from the screen, we can change the model. And this is also useful for getting this technical name of the model, which we will need in our code later on. We can also change the temperature and set the max token size for this model as well. We can also set the system prompt and the user message. For example, let's simply pass in hello, and for the system prompt, let's pass in something like you are a pirate. Optionally, we can add additional messages, and this will act as a sort of a conversation history. Let's delete this for now. Now we can simply click on run to execute this, and we do get our response back. Now, one useful thing about this dashboard is that we can click on get code, and here we can see the code that is being used behind the scenes to make this happen. And we can also change this from Python to TypeScript to see an example of that code. But in this video, we're not simply going to copy this code, but instead we'll write this from scratch so that we can get a feel for exactly how this API works. Also, we can click on this little button up here to upload images to this chat, and we can upload up to 20 images. And after uploading this image, if I click on Get Code, we will see that this code has now been adjusted to include the image as well. Now let's see how we can do all of this in our JavaScript Node environment. So open a folder in your code editor. I'm using VS Code. And then let's instantiate a new Node environment by running npm init-y. Let's make one small change to this package.json file. So below main, let's add type, and let's set that equal to module. Let's also create a file called app.js. And this file will contain all the main code for our project. In order to interact with these Anthropic models, we can either call the endpoint directly, or we can use an SDK. And in this video, I'll go with the SDK option, as it is very easy to use. But if you would like to learn more about the API itself, you can access this option from the dashboard called View All API Options. And in the documentation, you can see the API endpoint over here, but the body of this endpoint will be identical to what you will learn in this video. So this body will be the same irrespective of whether you're using the SDK or the endpoint. So back in our project, let's install a few dependencies. So let's run npm install .env because we will be using environment variables. And let's also install the Anthropic package, which is called @anthropic-app. AI/SDK. And let's hit enter. Great. Now let's get started with this project. The first thing we need to do is to import Anthropic from the Anthropic package. We can then instantiate this Anthropic class by creating a variable called Anthropic, which I will set equal to new Anthropic. And this class takes in an object as input with a property called API key. Now in order to get this API key, we need to go back to our console, then let's click on settings, then API keys, then click on create key, give your key a name, I'll call mine Claude tutorial, and then click on create key, then copy this key, and take note I'm going to delete this key after this recording, so please use your own key, and let's paste it into this field. We are now able to use this Anthropic object to interact with any of the Anthropic models. So we can do that by calling anthropic.messages.create, and this takes in an object as input, and here we have to specify a few properties. First is the model name, and I'm getting these values from the autocomplete, but if you don't have these values, you can actually get them from this dashboard by copying the values from this dropdown. Let's go with Haiku. Let's also set the max token size as 1000. Let's also set the temperature to something like 0.6. Let's set the system message to something like you are a pirate. And now we can also pass in an array of messages. So far, this should look very similar to what we saw in the console. So swapping back to the console for a second, we passed in the model, the temperature, and the tokens as well as a system prompt, and now we can add an array of messages. And for each of these messages, we are able to pass in text as well as images. And you will see that in the API as well, but I think seeing it visually like this does help. So for each message, we need to pass in an object, and for this object, we need to specify the role, which is user, as assistant represents the response from the AI, so that could be useful if you are building up a chat history. And besides for role, we also need to specify a content property, which is an array of values, and it is an array because we are able to pass in text as well as multiple images, up to 20 images in fact. So first, let's pass in an object which will represent the text in our prompt. So let's set type to text, and then let's pass in a property called text, and let's simply say something like, hello, how are you? We will have a look at passing in images as well, but let's first check that this is working. This create method will return a promise which we need to await. And let's assign the response to a variable, something like message. Now all we have to do is console log message to see the response. Let's test this in the terminal by running node app.js. And we can see this response coming back, and I highly recommend trying this for yourself. Next, let's have a look at passing in images to this prompt as well. But first, please support my channel by hitting the like button and subscribe. Now let's have a look at passing in images as well. First, I'm going to create a folder called images, and I'm then simply going to add this image for a fictitious restaurant. So this contains the name of the restaurant as well as some items with their prices. And at the bottom of this document, we can also see the phone number and the address of this restaurant. So let's have a look at passing in this image to the model and then asking questions about the image. So what we can do is to add another object to this user message. And let's set the type of this object to image. Then for images, we also have to specify the source. And source is also an object with three properties. First is the type, and at the moment we only have base64 as an option. Then we also have to specify the media type, and this can be GIF, JPEG, PNG, or WebP. I will select PNG, as this is the format of this image. Then lastly, we also have to specify a data property, and this will actually be the base24 representation of our image. So how do we get that? In Node, that's actually very easy to do. First, let's import fs from fs. This package will allow us to read files from the file system, and there's no need to install this package as it is included in Node. Now all we have to do is to read our image by creating a variable, and let's call this base64 image. You can call this whatever you want. Let's set this equal to fs dot read file sync, and read file sync takes in the location of the image, which is in images slash menu.png. And secondly, we can pass in an object, and this only requires one property, and that's the encoding property, which we will set to base 64. And this is all we have to do to fetch the image from our file system and then convert it to the base 64 format, which Anthropic expects. So let's grab this variable, let's pass it into this data field, and let's change our prompt in order to ask a question about the image. Like, what is the business name? Let's test this in the terminal, like so. And after about 2 seconds, I got this response back saying the business name is whatever this is. And if we look at the image, that is exactly right. Let's ask another question, like, what is the phone number? And we would expect this number down here. So let's change this to what is the phone number? Let's run this in the terminal, and indeed, we get the correct response back. Now, lastly, I do want to show you one very important tip. At the moment, we are exposing the API key in this code, which is not ideal. So what we can do instead is cut this API key from the code, then let's create a new file called .env, and we can now set a special environment variable, and the naming of this environment variable is important, and that is Anthropic_API_key, and let's paste in that API key. Now, this is special in the sense that Anthropic will automatically try and find an environment variable with this name, which means we can save this environment variable file, and in our code, we can actually omit this object completely, so the code only looks like this. And all we have to do then is to import the environment variables into our file. So at the top of the code, let's import all as .env from .env. Then we just have to call .env.config like so. And now if we run this code, everything still works. If you like this video, then you might also be interested in this other video on using OpenAI Vision to chat to images in a Node environment.